So all I've done is I've neatened up that edge. And this bit here is not as dark, so very subtle. Just why I'm going over here is I'm just putting in, if I've scratched things out that I don't want to. Like just in the lip here, I've just done a little scratch. Sometimes it does scratch off if you're using stencils and stuff. Highlight up here, but I want to get a mist up there first. So I'm going to start on this eye now. Blocking in the eye. Okay, and then it's the same principle as what we've done under this eye, is the drop shadow, but we'll keep it light and then build on it later. Thank you. Okay, we're going to go in with our wires again. So I'm just using a soft pink rubber now just to eke out a few little highlights at the top here. Yes. Bring those in. Got a little bit of texture in here and here. So I'm just going to bring in a little bit of texture, not a lot. And then we've got that highlight again. Might have to use the glass fiber again because it needs to look like the other side. It needs to be as bright as the other side. So it almost looks like makeup. And then I'll blow over it again with a mist. Just to put a little bit of texture in there. Get rid of that one that's a little bit too high up there. Pull him back into line. Just put in the little grooves in the teeth. This wants to be a little bit darker up in this area so we can really show that highlight. Now what we can start to do is start bringing in the shading. I'm just seeing the values are out ever so slightly in these areas, so just bringing them in a little bit darker. There's a little bit of a dark shadow coming out of that corner, so I'm just gonna hit that with a shield. And it kind of creeps out a little just there, and then there is a sort of squared off bit just here, just a tiny little bit of shade. We can go up just along that edge now. And I can start coming in this area. Trying to start to get that tone in there. It definitely wants to come round in a bit more of an arc, that eyebrow. So I'm just going to run along it. Doesn't matter if I get a few little marks in like I just got. So I'm just doing little daggers, blended daggers for the moment in the hair, just so I know where it all starts. Then I can kind of frame the face. Down the bottom here, comes out. I will be jumping around now from time to time. You can see we're starting to build up. I want to keep this as smooth as possible here. You notice I'm doing it from quite some distance away. Thank you. building up nicely. This will get darker. But I want to bring this jawline in first before I make that any darker. That's kind of where my jawline is, but it's a blended jawline as well, so you don't want it solid. Just filling in that part of the ear now. Just the inner part of the ear. Then I'll just use a shield to protect that ear. This one here, no, that one there maybe, yeah, just to block it in. That's it, and then I can come down from there that way. Get that shape right. Just can just come, this is all light, this bit. We want to keep, well, I say light, but we want to keep it fairly light. So I'm just pumping it down from a distance. And then the darkness comes up to that jawline. Like that. And we can block in come back in and use the shield around our roses. I'm just trying to, that's annoying. Just missing in this area now, bringing in so the cheekbone kind of goes up and joins the eyebrow. So what we want to do is come out of the eyebrow there and kind of come round and down like that. Okay, and then it kind of stops about there and then comes round again. Going to bring in this corner of this hair now, just darken it up. It pays dividends to stand back from your artwork and have a look at the reference photo and your artwork from a distance, because you can actually spot things. Like I can see on this cheek here, it just wants to have a little bit of darkness as it turns over that corner here. So, and I wouldn't have spotted that up close. So, and then there's this element that comes down here that goes up underneath the lip, just as a shade. So I wouldn't have spotted that up close. Yeah, I can see here underneath the lip, the shadow comes out a little bit more rounded. This comes over, almost over to in line with this tooth. So just need to bring that over just a little. Then it goes up again. So from there, on a woman's face, is very subtle, and it takes a little bit of shade and it throws the whole thing. Now I can bring in some highlights on this area here, like I was doing earlier. So we can now highlight this a bit more. Yeah, you can see I went up a little high on this black. I'm just going to drag a bit out of it so it goes more straight. That's better. I think I'll take this bit down here just out a little as well. All I'm using is, I'm not hardly rubbing at all. I'm just allowing the rubber just to scoot across the surface. Okay, we're getting there. We can highlight this part in here now, which is the lip. Bit of a mist just in there, not a lot. Right, I'm just gonna run over that corner ever so slightly so it straightens it up a bit and darken it up a bit. That's better. And I'll darken up this side. Now we got all these darker values down here. This doesn't look so dark. So I just need to get those a little bit darker in there. Just that makeup stands out a bit more. Look at that. Yeah, you got a nice shine on that lip now. Okay, we need a drop shadow on the teeth. I can see that. So I'm just going to come into the teeth area again. And do that drop shadow. And then there's a little tiny start of a V in this one as well, at the top. It is tiny. And then we need a bit of a darker line in that one. We have got a drop shadow that comes in there. Do a straight line up. Just punch off the side of the stencil. There is a straight line up that one as well, but I don't want to make it too wide. There we go. Bit more of a darkness up there, so less of an angle. And then we need to darken up this bit here. Actually, before I move on to the hair, there is a tiny little highlight on the top part of her lip, just up here. So I'm just going to punch that in, and then it goes up and over on this side. Just a little bit. That's better. Right, so let's start the hair. So the way we're going to do the hair is I'm going to go around the outside of all the hair. So let's start blocking in some of this darker background. And as I get close to the hair, I will get lighter and lighter. I want it kind of fairly light by the hair, just dark grey at the moment, because I'm going to be erasing it in. I don't want to make it too dark. Now beyond that point, look, I can start blocking in. See my wonderful fingerprints where I held the board. Stands out a mile. But as soon as that dries, we'll just keep shooting over it and it'll block them out. Dry it. I did use panel wipe to actually wipe the panel down, but oils in your fingers and grease in your fingers will still show. So try to refrain from touching your board after you've kind of wiped it. If anyone needs any advice on surfaces or anything like that, all you got to do is drop me a message and I'll tell you all about prepping your boards or your surfaces, whether you're gessoing a board or whether you're using dye bond board, whether you're using clay board, you know, whatever you want to use, I can give you guidance. So I can start blocking in this area, see if we come across any more fingerprints. But you can see that's already blocked out, that fingerprint. So we'll do the same on this side. We'll just come down, follow the hair, keeping it light around the hair and then we can start blocking in. And notice I'm pointing the airbrush away from our face. So any overspray is going to be heading that way, as you can see on the edge of the boards. We'll let that dry for a minute. Right, I'm just doing a darker kind of grey in the hair in this point here. So you can see I've left a bit of a loop there. You'll see in the reference photo there's a strands of hair that come out into the dark background. So I've made it grey. What we want to do is lay a base tone down over our hair. So we can erase the form of the hair out. Okay, now we've got our base in, we can start just looking at where these darker areas are. Don't have to get them exact because we know we're going to be erasing, right? So we just want to get these darker areas in. Don't want them black. We just want to know where they are. See, it's not detailed, it's all subtle at the moment. I'm just kind of positioning things. I'm just using little daggers just to throw up in that motion. If you're going tight, you'll get a nice thin line. If you come out a bit, you'll get that nice blended line. I'm almost creating a map to do my erasing. Got a bit of a mottled effect going on in there because my airbrush is not blowing the greatest, but I know I'm going to be erasing anyway, so I don't need to worry too much about it. This background stuff will all be blended out anyway. Bit more up this top bit and then we'll start erasing. It all looks very dark at the moment, but it won't when we're done doing the erasing. You notice the overspray really hasn't gone much on the face though, because I've kept the airbrush pointing out all directions apart from facing inwards towards the face. Okay, so we're going to now start erasing the hair out just to give us the form of the hair. So all we're doing is using a glass fiber just to start taking the hair out. In fact, I'll probably start here. Right, so now we've got a little bit of a block in there. I'm going to be playing about with it, crossing over with shields, etc., just to bring some layers into it. So as you can see, I've just brought this one forward and pushed the one behind back. So we're just layering at the moment. Just by doing little blocks here and there. Some of it still looks blurred because there's focal points of the camera, so I've got to kind of play about with it a bit. So we're just going to make this area really white want to get rid of most of the lines in this. Coming over the top. And then we'll mist over it all. Push back what we need to push back and keep out what we need to keep out. Right, I'm just going to push back some of this corner here. This is in the background. So we'll just make sure you get everything pushed back. Do a little bit on the right here. Under the neck, just start bringing this in, pushing up, get rid of any overspray. Minute, and then we just got to do round that edge. Just going to break up this hair now. Put another little curve in it as well, just a little break. And as it comes down, kind of goes off into darkness. Likewise with the background stuff. going to use the wires on the start of this hair up here as well. Start to push things back and bring things forward. Now just by adding a shield here, we can just push that lock back behind this one. Same with this over the top. Just push it back ever so slightly. So these hairs end up on top. We will have to do a bit more, but just get a sense of what's in front and what's behind. Not much longer to go. See, I'm just blocking things in. Push that back a bit. And just so it looks like it's going round the corner. This wants to be darker on the inside of the face. I'm just gonna put a shield there and that's it. To push those edges back, so that's now in front of that one. I'm gonna hit the middle of this bright one just to show it goes inwards and then out again. A proper circle almost in that one. It's like coming around in a loop. This one's got a dip to it, so I'm gonna just darken up that and then lighten up the bit coming out. I think I'll chuck a little bit of a split in it as well. say in there. That's it. Let's get something over the top of that one. Just push that back. That's it. Now we're kind of looking at just individual hairs. Really. If you put marks in your dark areas, just go in and touch them back in again. I'm going to hit this with some random X-Acto knife stuff now, just to make it look a little bit more realistic. So, no thought process goes into this, we just literally flick around. Literally, don't worry about what direction they're going. Just be completely random with it, because if you try and make it look uniformed, it's not gonna work. So you just gotta be completely random. Just don't worry about it. Same on this side. Just completely random. You can push some of it back. I think that is it done. That's it. And then I'll go in and just push back some of these random X-Acto knife, just to bring it all together. Just there we go. Well, I hope you enjoyed this one. We could bring out a few more highlights, actually. I'm quite happy with the way it's going. I think this is, you know, not pushing you too far. Just as one point, actually, I could come in here and just chuck in some wires to start with. You can see how that adds a little bit more to the start of the hair, whether you're doing light ones or whether you're doing heavy ones. It just gives you a sense of the hair taking off. But like I say, I hope you enjoyed this one.